Hello everybody, they call me Muse and I welcome you back to Shadow Gambit, the Cursed Crew. Cursed Crew. I've been trying not to say cursed because everyone in the game just pronounces it cursed. But here we are. We're back again. No, why are we still playing this? Sir. Because we are. And now let's go and speak to Red Marley before we waste any more time on terrible jokes.
This stone slab. These are the captain's words meant for us.
I couldn't help but notice. The stone is dripping with soul energy.
A gift from the captain. I've already drawn it out.
Lovely.
I believe we have enough to revive another crew member.
Just one, that's fair.
I will leave the decision to you while I ponder the secrets of the riddle.
Right, so I guess it's time for the looking at crew lightning round as we examine everyone's abilities.
Now we're getting somewhere.
So, we've got someone at the front here. Who are you, friend?
Mr. Mercury, at the ready!
So you're the shipwright. Anchor down, so he can open a portal to the below and he can hide. I guess he then just pops back up in the same spot. Anchor up. Oh no, he can return through another portal. And whack an enemy dead, so that's cool. And then Sir Reginald is a fish that presumably works like Mugen's sake in Shadow Tactics and just lures people over to take a look at it. So he is a body hider, because I guess he can hide people in his portals. And he can infiltrate and operate and navigate behind enemy lines. But you can't necessarily move people around. Very good. Now this was the other guy that we could have brought back initially, wasn't it, with the flute? Yeah, he's the other position changer that we could have got at the start. Maybe he's worth getting, just so we've got a couple of position changes and we don't have to rely on Salady all the time. Much as I love her.
Cannoness ready.
Gale is the cannoness. She can fire her cannon, which can shoot people, as far as the eye can see, knocking them out cold, as well as whoever they're aiming at. So she can knock two people out with the cannon blast, and she can lasso friendly crewmates into the cannon from somewhere nearby and firecrackers to attract people nearby. So she can use the firecrackers to change people's positions. Okay, but she can't climb or swim because she's got a big heavy cannon on her back.
Teresa.
Ah,
ready,
yeah.
To serve.
So you're the sharpshooter. So yeah, she was... I've had a look in the art book and I've seen that she was a former Inquisition member. And then she got blinded and possibly tortured and whatnot, and ended up on the crew instead. She can shoot two kinds of soul energy arrows over a very large distance, delivering lethal or temporary judgment. And she can also blind enemies with shots. So she's a killer and a sniper. But she's not terribly mobile, she's only got one leg. Kind of like Takuma from Shadow Tactics in that regard.
Von Preisfeld, at your service.
Now, Pincus. He can force his soul into the mind of an enemy and take over their body. So he could presumably take people over, walk them off to a quiet bush, and then when they pop out, he can bonk them. And he can use coins to get people's attention. So how's that going to work differently to the fish? We'll have to examine that. When he's disguised, he can move undetected alongside guards and through their view cone. So he's got a similar ability then to Aiko from Shadow Tactics, who could disguise herself as a courtesan and move amongst the guards. Cool. So he might need an infiltrator at some point.
Well,
he could do that job.
Golden greetings.
Quentin. Let's see. Treasure rod. He can pull friendlies around. He can draw Inquisition corpses into his chest to hide them, I guess. And can trigger levers and things from afar. And he can throw his head on the floor. And then, yeah, acolytes will come over and look at it. And then get murked. So he's also a position changer and a body hider. Can climb, can swim. Choices abound. I mean, we're getting them all sooner or later. We don't necessarily need another position changer right away. Because if the next mission requires three people, Then Selady could come along. And someone else. Do we get Gale? Or do we just get Quentin? We stood next to Quentin.
Always move forward.
Let's get Quentin.
Good morning. You must be Quentin Albers, the treasure hunter. You really do have a golden skull.
Ah, yes. The head. One of the less interesting bits of my possessions. Say, how much for that sword in your chest? I'll give you, let's say, 100 cursed rupees.
I'm afraid it's not for sale.
It's for stabbing.
That's what they all say. I'll file that one under negotiations ongoing.
The Navigator needs that sword for her power, treasure hunter.
New Navigator, you say? You sure she's not a spy here to steal my, our treasures?
As much as one can be.
This guy's a weirdo. I like him.
Regardless, we need you to head down to the training deck.
Yeah, I'll gladly throw the skull around a bit. But I expect a good treasure hunt soon, you hear?
Right, we're down in training. Let's see. I'll try and keep the training a bit quick and get into a mission, because I don't want this video to be like an hour and a half long or anything like that. But let's have a look at what we've got to do. So we can throw the head to use it as bait. Guards who see it will leave their position and try and pick it up. Yeah. Makes sense. And then we ruin their day. Whole lot of treasure hanging around in his training area, which is cool.
If there is value, it's mine.
So yeah, throw it into the... Yep. Yeah, basically telling us the same sort of thing.
An anchor in the sea.
And it's D. D is our...
Golden opportunity.
Okay, so it doesn't have a
With
huge
an
range.
Coin.
Is that...
Yeah, you come over and have a look, my friend. And then
I'll trade you for your life.
Get dead.
It's settled then.
And we will have back our coin. And how does he drag? So he drags people low on the ground. Okay. So he's like a fear in that regard. Some guards ignore the head. Okay, yeah. The more advanced guards will ignore the head.
Yeah, yeah, always the same. Haven't got a whole collection in my chest or something. No.
So yeah, you're going to ignore, but you're not.
Finders keepers, right?
So if we come over here.
A deal to remember, Marley.
And then we throw that there.
I can smell gold.
Only the acolyte will come. And yeah, he's now out of range of the commissariat, so we can knife him.
You'll pay with your demise. Another kind of bait.
Lovely.
And that's a big one.
And then I guess he did actually pick up the skull, so we've got the skull back now in our inventory. Good.
Smell gold already.
Now let's learn how to use our rod. Lol. So we can pull bodies and crewmates to our location. We can also interact with objects from a distance.
Will it yield coin?
So we need to unfold the ladder. Ah, cool. That's good.
The line spread. Hook, line and sinker.
Yeah, so far so straightforward.
Come to me trinkets, treasures, tricks and traps.
Use the treasure rod. Ah, we can trigger environment kills with it as well. This guy just got a little
treasured
cooler.
Memories. Let's reel them in. I'll take that one. Nobody takes what's mine.
Now, let's see what we've got down here. Use the treasure rod to pull crewmates. So, yeah, we can pull over a skeleton. Okay. Why are we... doing that, I wonder. Come here, bud.
Cursed day.
I'm still amazed how often fate conspires to lend use to your power.
Fortune favors the bold, and I have boldness.
Right, so we kill that guy.
Not yet. I'm still recovering. If there is,
and then we snatch him. Lovely.
To what's mine.
Oh, and we can hide in a pile of coins. Grand. Maybe I should have triggered that before I jumped down.
Takes what's mine.
Although, can we pickpocket from afar?
The rod reaches far. I'll take that.
Yes, we can. Good. So we can also pickpocket. So this guy's got a lot of use as a long-range manipulator.
Ah, a puzzle. There better be treasure at the end of it. It will be dealt with.
Right, so let's get down and into cover. Now we can pull that ladder down.
Hook, line, and sinker.
Doesn't do a lot for us right now. What can you see? Quite a bit. So we can't really take out that acolyte just yet. I mean, theoretically.
Diamonds, rubies, emeralds.
We could sneak up here.
You threw your net and captured a memory, Marley.
And yeah, we can deal with him. Like that. It's not the most subtle of solutions, but it works. And then we end up top. Okay. Drop a thing there. He will at some point see it on his way back. There we go. He's seen it. And this should be far enough away for the commissaris to not hear us. There we go. That should be this lot all out of the picture.
See you in the afterlife.
What are we looking at here? Commissaries can see quite a long way. That guard can see over there and there. That one can see around and about.
No escape from our base.
That's something that we can do, for sure.
What's mine.
We'll need that down the line. Those two can be taken out together with the cannon, if we can get over there. But is there a position we can move you to that this guy can't see? Because we can't turn the guards around. He can not see there, but then the commissarius can see there. What if we distract this guard to move him away so we can climb the ladder? Does that help us? It means we lose our skull for now.
My golden side. Nobody takes what's mine.
We got spotted. Okay. Yep, you go over there and have a look. And we'll make our way up here.
What is that?
Right, okay, so we're up here.
The line is sturdy. Find the keeper.
Something's amiss.
Yeah.
Treasure fishing!
Enough! Whoop. The case is clear. I shall resume my duties.
Okay. That kind of works nicely.
I can smell gold already!
Now, but you do see the commissarius.
He'll bite! Silver key, huh?
We got the key at least. Do we need to get our skull back? I feel like Quentin would want his skull back. Just because it's his skull.
An offer I can't refuse.
Can he lure it back?
The line is steady. Another kind of bait.
Yes, he can. Fantastic. We're not leaving without the skull.
If there is value, it's mine.
That's cool, the way you can hook back his skull. I like that a lot. That's challenge complete, and we can go about the next mission.
Well done, treasure hunter. The riddle hold awaits. I think you'll like this part.
Oh yeah, he's going to love this actually, isn't he? Chance to be part of the crew that goes through the door and get some mad treasure.
Quentin.
Aye, here to hunt for cursed coin and plunder the riches of the Lost Caribbean.
Two down.
Mordecai, you old devil! Hiding a treasure hunt right here and not telling little old me! I'd be furious if I wasn't giddy with excitement.
Now,
finders keepers.
We do have a crew tail that we could do, though. Do we start a tail with
remedies?
Let's
for
see.
The
dead. Salady's step two. Yeah, let's start with. Let's finish off Salady's crew tail before we worry about anyone else's, perhaps. So, converse with the Marley.
I do like this so far.
Ship doctor, I have news regarding your latest patient.
The one that's been talking funny, right?
Yes. I think it's up to something. It walks around on deck all day chatting to the others.
It's getting smarter.
It has never behaved this way before. Something is making it do this.
Some of the souls that are in it?
Interesting. All right, I'll shadow the little bugger and listen in on what it says.
So yeah, same sort of listening into conversation mechanics as earlier
Hello.
Games.
Oh, shiver me timbers. Huh? Shiver me timbers. Shiver me timbers. Goodbye. Shiver me timbers.
It's spreading.
There's that phrase again. That's clearly not normal. What kind of idiotic sickness is that? Even if it's harmless, it's probably spread to half the crew. Better round up the skelly so I can examine them. It'll go faster with some help. I'll ask Afia to lend a hand.
Cool. Now we're just going to bonk the skellies again. Where did I leave Afia? Where did she hang out when she's not my main person? Up near the navigator's table.
Yo, Afia, we've got a problem. Some skelly has been spreading some strange new kind of infection. Can you help me round up all the infected ones?
Sounds intriguing. So I'll lend you a hand. Shiver me timbers.
What did you just say?
I said I'll lend you a hand.
No, after that. You said a certain phrase.
Not that I'm aware of.
Then I'm afraid you've caught it too.
I don't feel different. But now that you say it, I did talk to a weird skeleton recently.
Well, at least you seem resilient to it. You've said the phrase only once so far. Maybe with your help I can figure out a cure. Would you mind giving me a piece of you?
I'm not sure what you... Ow! Did you just cut a slice from my leg?
Oh, it'll grow back.
It's
I'll head
fine.
For the sick bay now. Got lots of tests to do. Thanks for the sample.
Unbelievable. Shiver me timbers.
God. Yep.
Alrighty. It'll take some time to find out the cause of this infection. But just you wait, my sneaky little sickness. I'll have you cornered and cured in no time.
Excellent. So that's another bit of the crew tail complete. Now we can begin a mission. I kind of want to go back and replay old levels with new characters, but I don't want to do any crew tails off camera, so... I don't know.
This is good. We have made further steps in solving the riddle.
Found anything interesting in those cryptic rhymes?
I have indeed. I believe I know the purpose of the three bowls above the riddle room door. It's time we expand our reach across the timeless shores. Come to the map table.
I mean, they're bowls, so you think you're filling them with liquid.
Well, well.
Or possibly sand. Act 1 finished. Okay. Thanks, Jeev.
There are many islands in the timeless shores. The riddle tells us where to go.
Bark and bramble, ash and ore, bone and fingers.
Right,
those
so...
Those clues pointing to three
Bark
islands.
And bramble is the Dreadvine Cove. Yeah.
An island of wild nature and haunted flora.
I've read through the art book, so I know what some of the islands are like.
One of the Inquisition's furnace islands. The Isle of Penance. A prison of souls harboring an old associate.
Curious.
I believe they all hold relics. But the fourth clue is still a mystery to me.
We'll figure it out as we go. We also need more soul energy and black pearls.
We do.
The relics will most likely be imbued with energy. As for the black pearls... The twins of Narek Timoresh still owe us a favor.
Narek Timoresh.
Dreadvine Cove and the Iron Bay might also have pearls. I entrust the choice of heading to you, Navigator.
Sweet. So now we can go wherever we like, really. Let's see. We can just go back and play old levels, can't we? Oh, no. Maybe we can't just yet. Because, yeah, we got no missions available for those two. So, where do we go? Dreadvines? The twins might give us pearls?
Dreadvines Cove, a wild island overgrown by cursed flora. It is the seat of the mighty Dreadvine, an eldritch plant of incredible age. Its roots span across the island, creeping tentacles of bark and thorn that divide the very land with their presence.
Cool.
The captain once negotiated a pact between us and the Dreadvine, granting us safe harbor in its domain. Now the Inquisition has claimed the island, prodding and dissecting the Dreadvine even as it feeds on their souls. White marble now juts from the jungle like giant bones as the Inquisition do their work. Even in the shadow of the Dreadvine's terrible wrath, we will use the situation to our advantage and appeal to the Dreadvine in our hunt for relics and black pearls.
Yeah, let's do that. The idea of an island that actually opposes the Inquisition directly seems pretty cool. So we'll get soul energy if we complete Bark and Bramble. We'll get a black pearl if we complete Haggling with a Plant. They're both daytime missions. They're both medium size 3 crew. We need black pearls and we need Dreadvine. I don't know which is more important, but Dreadvine's bark might be required for the main story, as it were. Let's bark and bramble, shall we?
We've arrived. If my guess is correct, the relic of Bark and Bramble lies hidden here.
A bit vague for an island full of jungle. Where do we start?
Lost, are we, little pirates?
Yeah, that's dreadful.
How bold of you to enter my domain without even knowing what you are looking for.
Ah, Dreadvine. I see you're listening in.
This is my island, Marley. Nothing here escapes my notice or my wrath.
We have come in search of a relic the captain has hidden here. One of bark and cursed bramble.
So, you know the words. Then the gambit has begun.
Right, Dreadvine knows what's up.
You have it then.
Until recently. Unfortunately for you, the Inquisition has claimed it. Ignorant as they are, they had no idea.
Of course, it's three parts.
And split it into three parts. Do you see the crates that litter the harbor? Your relic is in three of them.
Since nothing on this island escapes your notice, do you know which three it is, eh?
That'd be too easy.
Of course, little pirate. But Mordecai wished for you to earn your prize. I am happy to oblige him.
Well, well. Espionage it is, then.
Yeah.
There is a commissarius on the beach. Listen in on his conversation, and it may lead us to our prize. Now,
well, we could just kill everyone. Navigator. Right, so we've got a bunch of different points, it seems. We could start right down the bottom. And then that would allow us to work our way up and unlock the doors, perhaps. Because, yeah, we're going to want to unlock all of the exit points at some point soon, rather than later. Maybe we'll start with the coastal huts, yeah. It's a lady. Quentin.
Where's the treasure?
And Afia. Ah, Afia doesn't appear to be locked in this time, so we didn't have to bring her along. But of course, we've got no choice, because we've only got three, so let's roll. Now, what is up?
Those constant nightmares.
Perhaps a confessor can help.
Don't mind me watching. I admit I am interested in how you will solve this test.
We are pirates, Dreadvine, not your personal objects of study.
Everyone on this island is subject to my study, be they living
water.
Right, so how far can that acolyte see?
If you lent my crew a hand.
Quite a way.
I have no hands. Only an insatiable interest in the mysteries of the soul.
So we can pop up here.
This plan's growing on me.
Do you have a pinch of ash for me?
Let's see.
Someone new in your crew. Who is the woman with a sword through her chest?
That would be me. I'm the Marley's new navigator.
A navigator?
Lovely.
A rather pointless world on a ship that navigates itself.
Yeah, Marley already told us that.
I can make myself useful. So far, I've yet to hear a complaint from the Marley.
I presume she merely keeps you around for company. An overrated concept, in my opinion.
That big shrub is quite full of himself, eh?
Yeah, he's a bit stuffy.
You don't know half of it. I could tell you some stuff that... Oh, never mind.
Yeah, what do you know, Slavey?
Oh, I so miss your cutting insights.
Is anyone
just
watching that guy?
Pretend I'm not here, yeah? All right, easy fix.
I don't see that anyone's watching this guy, you know.
This will be fun to come back to. Incoming! Next page. Up we go!
Yeah. That guy just dies. All is well. Is that guy going to notice that he's gone? Nope. But is there any point to coming this way? I guess I can rush up here and into that bush. And then when Commissarius comes back, we can just knife him up.
Fancy moves, lady.
Okay, cool. So we're making progress. We've worked our way up one side.
Let me just take notes
without
that one.
Too much issue. Now we could work our way around and clear out all the rest of these lads. Who are these purple ones? Are they... Either way, there are so many people on this island. This is going to be a long mission if we try and take them all out. But we don't need to take them all out.
I see.
Are you talking to the Dreadvine?
I have just the thing.
How curious.
I'm talking to a root. And it's talking back.
Yeah, he is talking to a root. And it's talking back. So that Commissarius can see just about, yeah.
I'm so afraid of you. You're not evil.
Okay. So maybe that guy's tricky to take out at this point in time. But we'd need to take him out.
Careful.
To take out that lad.
The Commissarius is making his rounds.
And that lad is guarding a door, yeah. We haven't got any way to turn guards yet. We can only push them. Yeah, you sneak into this bush. That's easy enough to them. And then if you freeze that guy, we'll pause it for a second. And then
treatment's ready.
Oh, how are you only frozen for a second? I guess, yeah, he's a Commissarius, isn't he? He doesn't get frozen for long. Curses. What about these two lads? That Commissarius has got...
I'm talking.
Watch me go!
And it's a lantern. Back.
What happens if we lure both of those two over here? Maybe we can do that with Quentin's skull.
Find his keepers.
Are they both going to come over? I feel like they're both going to get lured together because they're part of a... crew.
This was from the bar.
Oh no.
Why did you break the tower?
Or neither of them gets lured because the Commissarius.
I see.
Diamonds, rubies,
prevents the other one from going. Because he's too well disciplined.
I'm talking to
okay. Yeah, having the ability to turn a guard would be good. That might be my next goal. As it is,
standing
maybe
around,
we come this way.
Catching light.
May as well take out some more guys.
I know right where to cut.
You're feisty like a tangled web, lady.
And then that commissariat shouldn't be too much of a problem. We can always circle round and come back to that side of the island. Is anyone going to spot this?
Kill the body.
I gotcha.
No, good. Alright, okay, we've got an acolyte over there. We can see those steps, but you can't see above them.
Need some cover. Switch
so we could throw a bush up there.
Incoming.
And then we could get Quentin to pop over. And then when Quentin's over here, he can
golden opportunity.
Well now.
Lure a friend over. In you come, chap.
You'll pay with your ready to fire.
Lovely stuff.
It landed a heavy one.
Okay, so that's another dude out the way. Now we can circle round kind of over to this bit, perhaps. You can't see up there, but you can see down below. Is anyone going to notice? Yeah, that other acolyte might. But if we wait for that other acolyte to bugger off, where's he going? Yeah, he's going to come back. And when he's past that spot...
My best piece!
Is that?
Yeah, you come over.
An offer I can't... Another kind
you get
fact.
Knifed. A badge appears.
It's a deal then.
You get dropped in the bush. Good.
Fishing for
now,
an
this guy should be an easy kill.
You have what I want. That's a big one.
Excellent. So, Quentin proving his worth. Why is that skeleton just chilling there? He's having a good day. Let's not bother him. So we've got a commissaris down there. Is anyone really watching him?
Sign your treaty to die. Landed a heavy one.
Cool. Another guy down. And that guy's just walking back and forth, so he's an easy kill. We've got time to
memory
do it right
of
away.
The memory. That's a big one. If there is value, it's mine.
So yeah, we've kind of cleared out this side. I don't know if there's any value in clearing out this side, but
it will be dealt with.
If there is, then it belongs to Quentin. Now, can we drop down there? We can.
Oop. I can smell gold already.
You didn't hear or see anything. No alarms, please. Okay, so what's clearing out this side done for us? We can jump across there and across there. Who are you? You're a prognosticator. You're one of the big boys. And you're a Eudex. So you will guard the route.
I have no need for it.
This would be a good spot for Teresa the sharpshooter if we'd brought her on the mission. But we haven't. Then let's see. That's also another good way to... Well, is it a good way? How do I get over there? Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay, so that could all work. Yeah, that guy is looking over here.
Nobody take...
It's a powerful ability, this golden skull.
Oh?
You come over. And then I don't think anyone's watching this spot.
I'm not looking
I should have checked, but...
Ready to fire. Landed a heavy one.
It's fine.
I thought so.
Now, Eudex, you can't see over there. Can anyone see over here?
Can't yet.
Yeah, that guy can. Where does that guy see? Okay, he sees over to there.
My golden side.
He's going to come over. That's a long way for him to walk, but I'm okay with that.
Let's come to an accord.
And then
another kind trying to fight.
Ah, no, he's in range of the Eudex. Okay. But that's not a problem. We just need a second person over here, pretty much.
Remedies for the dead.
So, let's see if we can get Saladi over without too much trouble. We should probably get a fear over as well, just so that the whole crew is around and about. Hopefully she'll get here without setting any alarms off. Good. If we could put a bush there.
Where do I get those seats?
No. Can we get into that bush without being spotted?
Let me just take notes on that one. Oh, I like that.
Maybe we need to be a bit more careful about that. No, this guy comes wandering over.
Is that?
Oh, okay, he walks through Saladi's bush. Kind of a flaw in the plan. Right, so Saladi.
Hey! Shh. Try this fruit.
Yeah, reposition yourself.
Cover seats. You wanna hide, yeah? Coming right up.
Okay. We try the plan again. We should be able to just queue it up now, really. So, yeah. Quentin.
Sign your treaty to die.
Rush in and kill that guy. Saladi. Rush in and kill that guy. And let's go.
I like that. Kind of fight. Food for the
no problem.
Saladi dropped that guy off.
Don't tell me short.
Quentin dropped that guy. Good. That's a Eudex down. That's always useful. Now, because what I wanted to do was head down here and across and over here. Okay, that doesn't work.
Looks like we're trying it again.
Okay. Easiest way to see sometimes if something's going to work or not is just to do it. Yeah, a nice little bush. That should help.
One day I'll find out how you do it.
There is a guard who is looking over here, but
this plan's growing on me.
We're too fast. No one's really watching that acolyte when they come back over here, right? We go up the vine.
That noise.
Nope. Yeah, that's not going to work because we are too slow climbing up the vine.
Conspire against us. Is that strange?
But now it should work because we're already up the vine, so we should be able to knock them off nice and quick.
Incoming. Kill the body.
I gotcha.
Good. Now the prognosticator is seeing the Eudex, so we could kind of use all three of them over here. I think we're going to need two to take down the prognosticator, but that's fine. Oh yeah, we lost our bush, didn't we?
Oh,
so
I'll have to note that down.
Yeah, so lady, if you could
working on it.
Head back over here. Cool, we got everyone over. Let's bring them up.
Remedies for the dead.
Now, where does everyone want to stand?
Can we keep that one for later? A bush for hiding.
We could put a bush here.
Coming right up. Let's cover this up.
Prognosticator doesn't care. But that allows us to get everyone in position. So, let's see. Okay. So here's the plan.
I'll hold on to this.
Quentin.
I'm not looking for
stab that
ground.
Let's see. Yeah, stab that one rapidly. And a fear. I want you to blink to this one. And then Saladi is going to attack that one whilst he's busy. Bam! It works, first time.
Having? That's a big one. Will it yield?
Is this one of those situations where I didn't need to do this though, and I'm just doing things because it's a fun challenge?
I do like this.
Is there anything worthwhile up here? I
feel
like there was no reason to do that.
Watch
oh well. The main thing is we did it, and we did it properly. We've taken out the Eudexes at least, which might help. Who is that white arrow?
Let me add
Oops.
Him.
Right, so that's an alarm acolyte.
Is that?
Sign your treaty. Ready to fire. That landed a heavy one.
Excellent. So that's another guy down. Now, is anyone watching this guy? Doesn't look like it.
Let's come to an accord. Finders keepers. Right.
There's a crate there. Oh, it's got gun ammo in it. We've not used the guns yet. They're not very stealthy. But I guess they might come in handy at some point. So we've only got three guys left here. Commissaris is looking at that guy.
It will be but
neither of them are really looking over here. Okay, that guy was. Very well. Ah, he's a dev as well. Right, so he swings that way, so let's bring up Salady.
Need something, matey.
You can always pop down a new bush just about there. And then we can bring in old Quentin. He should now be able to get into that bush. Although, actually, yeah. That guy is still going to get spotted if we skull him anywhere, so let's bring Salady into that bush as well.
Itching. I do like this so
Oops.
Far.
Didn't mean to jump down there, and now probably can't get back up without getting spotted by that lad. Oh, no, we can. Good.
This plan's growing on me.
And then where's Afia? We should probably get her in the let's action at up. Some point. Okay, Afia. Kill that guy. Salady. Oop. No. Kill that guy. Quentin. Kill that guy.
Oh, no problem.
Yeah, triple kills. And then everyone can drop off their bots.
What do we have here?
Sweet. Right, we've got more buggers talking to the roots over here by the look of it. And we've got Juan Florido, who is another dev.
One left. Up we go.
Cool, that guy's easily taken down. I guess he was easy because we've already cleared out this route, and he would have been harder to get to via another method. That Commissarius shouldn't be too hard to take out if we time things right. We can sneak behind him and into this bush.
Well, no.
Okay, we can't. Wait, we don't even need to. We can make our own bush. Now, there was a badge for distracting people during conversations with Salady. So, although we could just take this guy out right now, may as well make some progress on that badge.
Let's send you away.
Yep.
Three little cuts. Oh, no problem. Oh, this is fascinating.
Lovely.
Oh,
no. I must resume my task.
Yeah, you resume your task.
Someone is neglecting their task.
Oh, he's looking about, is he?
The maiden waits for no one.
Treatment's ready.
Well,
food for the
good thing I'm too quick. And down goes another. Oh, we got a couple of kindred over there. That's fine. We got a cave as well. Yeah. I don't think anyone else is going to be
again,
watching if this guy gets distracted over there.
Commissarius Muscle.
I drive a deadly another kind of bait.
Cool, another guy down. Now, that one has got a couple of people watching him that aren't. So that guy needs to go. This guy is fine because he comes in range of the custodians. That guy's in range. Yeah. So that guy up there needs to go. Let's worry about that in a bit.
That's a big one. An offer I can't refuse.
Okay, another guy down. Now, how does one. That feels like a Salady opportunity. Yeah.
Need some cover?
Much obliged.
Alright. Pop a bush up there. And then there's a lady there. You can't really see up, can? Oh yeah, you can. Okay. You can see up far enough. Now, can this just be done?
You threw your net and captured a memory, Marlin.
Standing around, catching light.
So, we'll kill you. But first, we'll get Quentin to move in. There we go. We timed it right.
We found no common ground. Landed a heavy one.
And then everyone can get their bods into bushes. And that's the kindred down. Now, Salady, can you jump straight into that bush?
This plan's growing on me.
You can. Is anyone going to notice if we shank this guard?
Interesting choice, Marley.
Yes, that guy is. Yeah, they're watching each other. Okay. Right, but if they're watching each other, that's fine. Because Quentin can jump down here.
If there is value, it's mine.
We can get a double kill.
Oh, I like that. Kill the body.
I gotcha. My chest is off limits.
Lovely stuff. Two more down. And is that this little section cleaned out? Kinda. There's still three guards back there that we've not really dealt with. Yeah, that acolyte can be dealt with without too much trouble, I feel. So, come on, Quentin. Now, let's drop a skull there.
Whispers from the bar.
Is that? Okay, that's slightly out of range.
Ready to fire.
Let's drop it there. Yep, you come over and have a poke.
You'll pay with your demise.
How dare they let me wait?
But landed a heavy one.
Have you forgotten your sacred duty? Hello?
Cool.
I'm waiting.
Now it's just custodes.
Taking a break, are we?
Ock is another kind of bait.
Now, Salady is probably the best bet because she's a quick killer. Good.
It'll grow real fast. Swift shrub coming through.
And then she can take this lad out without any trouble.
It'll only hurt a bit. Up we go.
Afia's just been left behind this mission.
Need something, matey.
She's kind of got generically useful abilities, but nothing special. As you might expect from the first character. So, yeah. She's not as cool as the others. So that acolyte has got a big long range. Let's get Salady again. Because her bush ability is just too damn useful.
My orders are clear.
Okay. Can we make it?
Well, no.
Oh, we almost made it. Not even sure what my plan was at that point.
I do like this.
Although,
so far.
Yeah, my plan is probably a fear. To be honest.
Covers.
So let's see. Where exactly does that Roman guard go? He comes over here. He walks across that bit. So if we put a bush there.
I don't remember that bush. Well, my
opportunity calls.
That should be fine, because we can bring
I
up the
like
fear. Oops. Bring her up this way. And then she can blink into that bush. Good. Now she is in a position, I feel,
a moment to remember,
where she can
blink
into that guy.
Ah, let's stretch those roots.
And then, let's see.
This plan's growing. One
bam. Doorway.
Oh, no problem. Three little cuts.
I'm just going to knife all these guys just because.
Incoming.
Just because I can, really. Cool. So that's everyone taken care of there. That's that door taken care of. Still two guys over there, though. Did we fail to quick save again? Looks like we did, you know. So I guess this is a job for Quentin this time.
You have what I want.
Cool.
That's a big one.
And now that those two lads are taken out once again, I did see a little ladder up here.
Come, fishy, fishy. It's a deal then.
No, don't go that way, Quentin. You silly man. Go there.
The rod reaches far.
There we go. We used his ladder ability at last.
I can smell gold already.
Yeah, we'll work our way up this right side of the island, and then we'll work our way back down the left, I think. It's going to be a long video. This is probably a two-parter, to be honest. Maybe at this point we'll sign off, and then I'll see you next week for the conclusion of this mission. Thanks for watching, friends.